from the Saudi capital of Riyadh, in a town called Qatif, an 18-year-old woman, soon to be married, was riding in a car with her ex-boyfriend last year when they were kidnapped and brutally attacked. The first man with a knife raped me, she said. After the seventh one, I couldn't feel my body anymore. All seven came back and raped me again. A Saudi court sentenced her attackers to prison terms and lashes, but then also sentenced the woman to 90 lashes for privately meeting with an unrelated male, a violation of the country's strict Islamic law.
After following several cases, this is the most clear, unjust sentence that have ever been made in a public case like this.
The rape victim did something rare in Saudi Arabia. She appealed. The court recently responded by more than doubling her sentence to 200 lashes and 6 months in prison.
She is devastated right now. She's very depressed.
The Saudi government denied permission for NBC News to shoot in Qatif, but we spoke to the victim's husband by telephone. He says the judges saw the rape as his wife's fault and treated her as a criminal.
Here we have a victim that was not treated as a victim and was actually punished. Here we have the Saudi Arabian authorities doing the opposite of what they should be doing.
And the Saudis have responded to international criticism by escalating allegations against the woman, now claiming she confessed to an adulterous affair. But her lawyer says the government's new claims are not true. The case has triggered a broader debate inside Saudi Arabia about treatment of women who live under a strict dress code enforced by religious police. Can't drive, can't vote, and can't work without permission from a male relative.
This shows the need of immediate action, reform towards women rights and women rules and regulations in the country.
The White House has condemned the woman's sentence, calling it outrageous. The Saudi foreign minister told U.S. reporters that unfortunate things can happen in the courts, and the sentence will be reviewed. But so far, no word on whether the Saudi king will use his power to overrule the courts to prevent this from happening to other Saudi women. Lisa Myers, NBC News, Washington.
Legendary commandos of feudal Japan. But I didn't have to travel all the way to the other end of the world Instead, a small school in the heart of Iran is where I learned about the vast array of skills that they use, namely ninjutsu. There are currently 3,500 female ninjas officially training. They say the world of ninjutsu has actually taught them how to maintain mental and physical balance. In order to develop the skill to use those deadly weapons, students need to learn how to be quick and focused. This is the object of all their indoor practices.
At Fire Station 400 outside Tehran, women do all the work. Suiting up, loading up, responding to a fire a day. 11 women on 24-hour shifts in the Middle East's only female fire brigade.
You do everything the same as the men, no difference?
Yeah, no difference. In every mission, it's the same as men. Because of this, I think that we are so special, so maybe powerful.
Zore Vatanka isn't sitting in the back of any bus. She's Iran's champion rally car driver. Of her last 40 races against men, she's placed in the top three every time. When I started this job, she says, the men would laugh at me. They don't laugh anymore.
It's one of the toughest sports on earth. Physically demanding, it gives these Iranian women a chance to let off steam. Practicing in a sports field on the outskirts of Tehran, they're members of the capital's rugby team and number one in Iran's women's league. And you can see why. Absolutely focused, they are as competitive as you can get.
These women are students, accountants, engineers. They say that rugby gives them a sense of excitement they can't find elsewhere.
That's what attracted Zahran Nouri, the team's captain and a member of the national side. She says there are no differences between men and women on the sports field.
We women have no restrictions here in the sports that we play. Even our football players have shown that to play in competitions there are no limitations. We do the same sports as men and we enjoy it a lot.
We love this sport and our hijab has no bad effect. In fact, we really like it. It's no barrier to this sport.
The game here is relatively new. The national team's only been playing for a year. These women hope one day they'll be good enough to compete against the very best in the world. Nazanin Mashiri, Al Jazeera, Tehran.
A young festival dedicated to the role of Iranian women in the society. The Parveen-e-Tesami Film Festival, which is named after Iran's prominent 20th century female poet, came to an end in the Iranian capital, Tehran. The event, which hosted more than 500 female Iranian filmmakers and cultural activists, was held in two national and international sections.
I think the Parveen-e-Tesami Festival can play an effective role in improving the quality of the works of female artists and also the status of women in our society, because this is where the art, the thoughts, and the vision of our female artists is reflected and observed carefully.
The event, which celebrated its 7th anniversary, introduced the best films and animations of the year, chosen by a jury comprising some of Iran's best critics and documentary filmmakers. The organizers of the festival also took the opportunity to express gratitude towards a number of women who had served in the war front during the 8-year Iraq-Iran war.
This is like a launch pad, an opportunity to ascend. With more artists comes more competition, and this is how the quality of the films will get better and better.
One of the attractions of this year's event was the presence of Hamid Bahmani among the participants. The former professional documentary filmmaker and cameraman had lost both eyes by depleted uranium munitions in a U.S. bombardment in Iraq during the Second Persian Gulf War. But lack of sight did not prevent him from making a film about the capabilities and the challenges facing blind women in Iran. With a short film titled Midnight Rainbow, he introduced himself as the world's only blind film director.
This film was made by heart. Luckily, with the producer's support, we managed to round up a group of professionals to make this short film. By making this film, I also wanted to say that despite being visually impaired, our minds are not limited and people like me have many physical capabilities. We only have to put up our mind to it.
The 6th National and 2nd International Parveen Ehtisami Festival kicked off on January 1st. This festival emphasizes the important role of Iranian women in the society and reflects their capabilities through the works of female filmmakers.
The Parveen Ehtisami Film Festival is all about women. According to the organizers of this event, Iran has the largest number of female filmmakers among the countries in the region. As the number of films made by or somehow related to women in Iran is on the rise, this festival aims at what it regards the golden era of Iranian female filmmakers in the future. Amir Mehdi Kazemi, Press TV, Tehran.
Nowadays, the vast majority of scientific society in our country consists of female. Actually, they have played a prominent role both in industrial and academic communities for past decade. To my way of thinking, they are brilliantly successful in doing their responsibilities in all aspects of their life.
Scientific fields have always been more receptive of women. They have made contributions and sacrifices to science from the earliest times.
Scientific or technical, successful women are now seen everywhere.
As I was taking a tour in Ruyan Court Blood Bank, I noticed more female faces than males.
I really liked to become a doctor when I was a child. I don't know why I didn't even go for it. Maybe I was too lazy.
According to the national statistics, female with postgraduate degrees can easily find relevant jobs. After seeing women participating in different fields, one question was raised for me. And that was, how are women doing in universities? That's why we have come to one of the most credible universities in Tehran to ask this question.
As the statistics show, females make up 70% of university entrances in scientific and medical related and humanities majors. Although there are still majors that are more selected by males, the toll of all majors adds up to show more girls entering and educating universities in Iran today.
So at the level of education itself, I think this is very remarkable, the level of participation of women. And that shows a lot of a lot of energy, a lot of effort that they have put into this, which is a very good development, but we should also prepare the ground for them in order to join the society after graduation to find proper jobs.
Getting into the master's degree or the bachelor's degree is one case, and finding a job in that case is different.
I'm against my friend and about the higher education. I don't think that the single other interns about to hire in the PSN.
From what I see between my friends, it's not a matter of really finding the job or the fact that you cannot find the job or your income is low. It's because your main goal in the beginning was wrong. So once you graduate, you don't really care to find the job that you're looking for because your aim was different than what it should be.
I think the most important reason that now women are more willing to continue their education, go to universities, or find a job in the society is because of our past background. And now they have a kind of freedom.
It's true that after all, the number of active men in the society beats out women. However, the number of women taking part in the country's political, economic, and civic life shows that women are growing fast in the Iranian society. Mahsa Mortazavi for Iran.